You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of Slaughterhouse-Five, a famous work by Kurt Vonnegut. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. Kurt Vonnegut Jr. was born in Indianapolis, Indiana, in 1992. His father Kurt Sr. was an architect, and his mother Edith was from a wealthy brewing family. Vonnegut wrote for and edited student newspapers at high school and Cornell University, where he found writing to be more enjoyable and less stressful than his degree in biochemistry. Having enlisted in the U.S. Army in 1943, he was sent to Europe in late 1944, captured soon after, and lived through the Allied bombing of the German city of Dresden as a prisoner. When he returned home, he married Jane Marie Cox and studied anthropology at the University of Chicago, working as a reporter at night, before becoming a full-time writer in 1952. Vonnegut's early novels were extremely varied in style and content, sometimes containing elements of science fiction, and were moderately successful. He rose to fame when his 1969 novel Slaughterhouse-Five became a bestseller. He wrote sporadically for the next decade due to personal difficulties, but then published a series of successful novels through the 1980s and 90s. He died in 2007 in New York. Today, Vonnegut's work remains extremely popular with the general public and is also widely studied in academic environments. Fellow writers often comment on the ease with which he wrote, despite the fragmented style he employed and the often difficult and painful subjects that he tackled. The work. Between the 13th and the 15th of February 1945, the British and U.S. Air Forces bombarded the German city of Dresden with high-explosive bombs and incendiary devices, causing a firestorm that completely destroyed the center of the city and killed approximately 25,000 people. A group of American prisoners of war survived in a meat storage bunker underground, among them a 22-year-old Kurt Vonnegut. For years after the war, Vonnegut struggled to write a book about Dresden, finally publishing the semi-autobiographical novel Slaughterhouse-Five in 1969. Following an opening chapter which deals with the author's troubles in writing the book, the novel tells the story of Billy Pilgrim, whose life shares many elements of Vonnegut's own wartime experience. Since Billy is subject to a kind of involuntary time travel, the narrative makes seemingly random jumps between the lead-up to and aftermath of the bombing and different parts of Billy's post-war life, as a successful optometrist. Bizarrely, these episodes include Billy's abduction by aliens and his time spent on the planet Tralfamador as an exhibit in a zoo. With its jumbled narrative and decidedly non-heroic protagonist, Slaughterhouse-Five portrays the senselessness of war from the perspective of the ordinary young people whose minds and lives are profoundly altered by it. Summary. A note on the novel's structure. Slaughterhouse-Five has a distinctly unconventional structure. The narrative takes the reader back and forth in time, and to a planet 446,120,000,000 miles away from Earth, as Billy Pilgrim involuntarily travels through time to different parts of his life. In this guide, the events of Billy Pilgrim's life are summarized in chronological order, after a brief summary of the novel's opening chapter, in which a narrator describes the challenges of writing a book about Dresden. Writing the book. A veteran of World War II spends the 1950s and 1960s attempting to write a novel about his experience as a prisoner of war in the German city of Dresden during the firebombing of the city by the British and American Air Forces. After several years spent studying anthropology and working as a reporter and then a publicist, he eventually contacts Bernard V. O'Hare, a friend from the war, and arranges a visit to discuss material for his book. Their discussion proves fruitless, but Bernard's wife Mary extracts a promise from the writer that he will not glamorize the war or the young soldiers who fought in it. After a tour of Eastern Europe with O'Hare, which includes a trip to Dresden to conduct research for his book, the writer is finally able to complete the novel, whose protagonist will be called Billy Pilgrim. Billy Pilgrim's childhood. Billy Pilgrim is born in 1922 in Ilium, a town in New York State. He grows into a tall, awkward-looking youth, who is traumatized by his father's attempt to teach him how to swim by throwing him into the deep end of a pool, and by the graphic crucifix that his mother hangs on his bedroom wall. Aged 12, Billy visits the Grand Canyon in Arizona and Carlsbad Caverns in New Mexico with his mother and father. He is intensely frightened by the depth of the canyon and the darkness of the caves. Billy goes on to do reasonably well in high school. Billy Pilgrim in World War II and its aftermath. After enrolling in the Ilium School of Optometry, Billy's studies are cut short by the intervention of the United States in World War II.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.